Well, this was not a tappy-tappy. This one came roaring out from underneath that junk and said, hello! Hello! Hey, Rudy. We had a pretty decent day today, and I'm going to try to catch a fish for Mom. Does that sound like a good idea?
Well, yeah, I think that's a pretty good idea. Well, are you going to interrogate me again on what sort of thing that you should use for fishing?
Yeah, I need your help again. Rudy, can you give me some idea of what a fish would do if it grabbed this? I should use it, right? Let's shake on it.
That's my boy. He tells me all the good news and all the good suggestions. Thank you, Rudy. You're a really good boy.
Well, friends, we're headed to do some bass fishing, believe it or not. I think this is Henry County, Missouri. Somewhere in Missouri, you know how that goes. We had one heck of a storm last afternoon and evening. That is the first rain since 29 days ago. So it has been extremely dry around here. I need to grade this road a little better. I'll just stop here for a second. With that storm last night, and the no rain for all that period of time, I have no idea what's about to happen. So if you're ready, I'm ready. Let me get on down this road as best I can, and we'll go fishing. Does that sound all right? Wish me luck. Hey,
to say that due to that drought I mentioned on the way in, this pond is at its lowest level I have ever seen it. So whatever's left out there is probably concentrated in about a 2 foot by 2 foot space. I'm going to put my flippers on here on the bank and attach my measuring bar and net to the D-ring on the outside of the tube. Push it out there a little bit and just sit down and turn around. Man, it's hot. I think Rudie and Leila have got a solution for what to do when it's hot. Let's take a look.
I got a hot day. Have to get cooled down.
Ice?
How about you, Leila? You want some ice? What can I say?
I hope we can find something in there, like that one that's moving, that haven't died of thirst. Mr. Snake, he's all right. Unfortunately, there's no front cargo area, so I'm just gonna have to throw this stuff over the side and tow it along. And I inflated the backrest and pulled out the spreader bar. This side of the spreader bar is clipped in, but it's not inserted yet. What I typically do is just connect one of the apron straps on this side, wait and do the other one later on. Because sometimes if you get in like right here, you couldn't put the spreader on because your knees would be in the way. So since this does not have a foam seat, but just simply a canvas seat, I'm gonna turn around and sit down and I'm gonna be at eye level with Mr. Snakey. Turn it around, sit down. But you see what I'm talking about, Victor? I can't put that spreader bar on just yet. See? So I'll wait to put it on when we get out into actually deeper water. Feels cool. I might have to jump in it and take a shower before I leave. There essentially is no front deck to these little bitty tubes. They're made to be light. Mr. Strikey Strikey right there should never turn the camera off. There he goes. Come on, buddy. Come on, pal. Let's get in that room. There you are. He's not a bull, but I'll just pinch him. There we go. Wow. Very nice. Fat, healthy. You have a powerful thirst. This fat little bass comes in at 15 and a half, 15 and three quarters. Okay, Tim. That's my friend who keeps dragging in 5 and 6 pounders. This is a dink compared to what he keeps catching on the buzz bait. Enjoy catching you. See ya. I think it's on a mustad keeper type hook. Probably at least 3, possibly 4-aught. Does a pretty good job. Little legs flap and attract fish from, I don't know, the next county, I guess. Yawn. Fun though. Bamboozled me. Still quite a bit of commotion and splashing fairly near the moss line, so let's see if they want something underneath the water. RTR. Reaping team. Reaps. Yeah. And the net result is, that's a nice fish. All right, Lorraine. If this is your hand, this is my hand, score! I was actually throwing this Grim Reaper as I would a grub. Just throw it over there and kept the rod tip up high and just reeled it. And he came flying out from that junk and grabbed it. Okay, let's see what we got here. Wow. That's a very handsome fella. Yeah, that's a good, healthy fish. Very pretty. Now, don't you be jumping. 17 and a quarter. I'll get your picture and send it to Sparky, because I know he's been up to no good and he needs to be cheered up really bad. Okay, don't go away. Thanks for stopping by. Hope to see you again. And hope you don't die of thirst. Little guy. What are you doing up in there chasing that reaper?
I don't know. I just wanted to be reaped.
Well, consider yourself reaped. Okay, I'm going to abandon my original plan simply because I was getting lots of taps and yanks and stuff and coming up dry. So I've never fished a micro finesse anything in this pond. So there's a first time for everything. Well, this was not a tappy tappy. This one came roaring out from underneath that junk and said, "Hello!"
Oh my goodness.
Here you go, buddy. Thank you. Yeah, it might be cheating to throw a micro finesse on medium action gear, but who cares? Yeah, you're a nice stocky fella, aren't you? We like it. Hey, Mikey. 16, possibly a little over. These sharp little hooks really do the job. All right. Catch you next time, I hope. So I'm using this beaver creature bait kind of like a frog. Want to know the truth? Because this water is pretty shallow up in here, so I'm just sort of twitching it along like a frog, keeping it high in the water column. There he is. What are you doing?
I want that little creature bait.
Oh, you do. It's fairly obvious here. Nice. Well, we're fixing to call this shindig to a halt. Thank everybody for coming along today. It was good to get out of the house. Just about everything worked. It was kind of like junk fishing again. Not much to write home about, but just a nice little excursion, taking a break in between what appears to be an upcoming monsoon season for the next few days. So who knows what's going on. And thanks for coming along. Hope you enjoyed the show, and we will catch you next time. God bless. Bye-bye.